We are here with P2 versus Hector Hartmut for World Cup. P2 is on Team UK, United Kingdom, and Hector Hartmut playing for Canada. He also played a game yesterday, 5 AM my time, and my internet died, so I couldn't record that. I watched it on phone, I was still up, I'm insane. And I don't think that was the best game, so I'm okay that I missed that game. But yeah, I bring some Mega Mawai squad. I assume it's Scarf Greninja on Hector's team. Is he move Zygarde or is he move Lando? I'm not sure about that yet. And yeah, on P2's team, I assume it's Max Defense, Clefable. I mean, P2's team is pretty standard bulky offense. Just like 1 or 2 months different from other teams that already exist. Yeah, either Scarf Lady or Scarf Greninja on P2's team, but I could also see Ash Greninja with Scarf Lady. Z-move Tapu Bulu. I assume it's Rocks Clefable and either Sub Toxic Trin or Taunt Toxic Trin. But you never know, P2 might be insane and bring some T-Wave, Calm Mind, Clefable. But he switches out Zygarde 1, scouting for Ice Beam, and we see it's Protean Greninja. Yeah, like I said, it's... I mean, I was thinking if it's Ash Greninja, I was thinking it was a Scarf Lady, but we see Protean, we see no item, so this makes me think it could be Scarf Ninja. And so do Lady or Specs Lady. But yeah, Hector's Greninja, I'm pretty sure it is Scarf, and it's gonna go for U-turn here, because Rock Slide just gives P2 too many switching opportunities. Like potential Zygarde. Oh, he goes for spikes. And he's not Protean. I thought he was Scarf, so he's Ash Greninja. So Hector is gonna be Scarf type of Lele, wow. Unless he's a Scarf Ash Greninja with spikes, which is no set. No way that is a set. Like I refuse to believe that is a set. So P2 has T spikes, which is interesting. So they're both not Scarf Greninja. So you already know. I'm predicting the Scarf was wrong, like it's my job, and I assume it's gonna... Now I know it's probably Scarf Lady, man. He brings in the Mauler, predicting an Ice Beam. I don't know why, like what? The thing is, the T-Spikes are coming in clutch. Hector doesn't have that control. The Tapu Lele and the Tangrowth were gonna get chipped down, and the Zygarde 2, and I assume he dies to a Pump or HP Fire here, exactly. And I could see his being Expert Belt. Probably Expert Blade. I don't think it's Splash Blade. First I thought it was Scarf, like I said. But he can live a pump from this range. The last move on this Greninja should... I don't know if it would be mixed. My man Survey uses a double spikes Greninja, T spikes plus regular spikes. But I think he has 3 attacks on this. If he predicts the type of Wooly, he can go for Ice Beam here. That would be an interesting play. But he just goes for Hydro Pump, which is understandable. Because you want to be able to kill the Greninja, and I don't know if Ice Beam would kill it from 28. So this is a tough spot for Hector Hartmut. I assume he's 4,000 to his Landorus here. If he sacks his Greninja, pretty much it doesn't help him, because the Horn Leech will just heal the Tapu Bulu all the way back up. Yeah, I think P2 wins this. Like, it looks pretty good for him. He just plays it safe, goes for Horn Leech. He doesn't lose anything from by doing that, because if the Lando comes out, he gets to find out if it's Helmet Landorus or potential Z-move Landorus. And yeah, if the Tangrowth comes out, like, no matter what, he just gets some health back. And Tangrowth has to take the T-Spike damage, chip damage anyway. And this gives him a free switch in to Clefable. I mean, he would lose his item if the Tangrowth would go for knockoff. The thing is, he doesn't even have to switch. If he has SD on his Tapu Bulu, he can even go for SD here. So if I'm Hector Hartmut, if I predict the SD, I would go out into Tapu-Lele, if Tapu-Lele is, because Tapu-Lele will be able to change the terrain and then potentially threaten this out. So that's an option. Or if he has Iron Tail on Zygarde, that's another option. But I can also see P2 attacking again, breaking the switch. As P2 just brings out the Clef, which is just a safe play. And even Hard into Zygarde, I think he predicted SD. And I think he has Iron Tail on this. And yeah, P2 is just gonna click Moonblast here, I think. Because going into Heatran is a bit too risky. You never know, like he might just click Thousand Arrows if he doesn't have Iron Tail, so going Heatran is too risky here. But P2 is definitely in the driver's seat as he eats it up and gets up the rocks. Wow, I really thought he would've I think I would've gone for Moonblast there every time, like. He doesn't have Moonblast resists at all, and if the Zygarde stays in, I want damage on the Zygarde, but getting up rocks is nice too, obviously. But I just would've preferred to get out damage on this. But yeah, now this is clearly banded Zygarde. So I can see P2 staying in, predicting Hector to double into something that beats Heatran. Hector might go into Landorus here. Goes into Greninja. Yeah, like basically something that beats Heatran. Which would be Greninja or Landorus, but I thought he would go Landorus because Gren is already weakened a bit. I mean, he has aggressive terrain to help him out, but he still has to take some damage from T-Spike. So he has to protect Heatran, so this is a really cool strategy because the T-Spikes support this. It also helps out with Z-moves, it also helps for to scout for choice locked Pokemon. I like this a lot. And we see it's Dash Greninja goes for Dark Pulse, potentially predicting P2 to pivot into Lati. And Clefable was low, so we've gotten 2-hit killed by Dark Pulse. And yeah, I think he anticipated P2 to go out into Lati to prevent Greninja from getting off the Ash form, because if Heatran stays in, it dies to Hydro Pump and he gets off the Ash form. But yeah, he was already in the bag, so I can understand that he wanted to predict the Lati, but I don't think P2 had to make that play. But yeah, this looks pretty clearly on P2's favor. If that's even correct English, my grammar is sometimes not the best. And he sacks off the Clefable to the banded Thousand Arrows, which is completely understandable because Tapu Bulu might have gotten 2-hit killed after a spike, not really sure, but Tapu Bulu is still useful. If it comes in on the Lele and changes the terrain, it might be able to live a hit, and it's definitely useful for the Tangrowth. So I'm thinking this is a Z-move Landorus and Scarf Lele here. And he's gonna go for Ice Beam, I assume. As the Tangrowth should get 2-hit KO'd from this. Yeah, I think that's expert build. I'm not really sure, but I think so. I don't really feel like calking at the moment, but this is a quick game with God. He's already up 5-3 and Tapu Lele. Would he click Focus Blast or... No, the Greninja is changed, so he can click Psychic. Greninja changed its typing, I was about to say. He doesn't have to click Focus Blast, it's not a Dark type at the moment. Yeah, we will find out if the Lele is Scarf here, if the Greninja stays in, but I'm pretty sure it is. Which, I mean, yeah, he has some counterplay to Zygarde, like some checks. Which is Zygarde. Did I say Zygarde? I meant Volcarona. I don't know if I said Zygarde, I meant Volcarona. He has some counterplay to Volcarona, which is his Ashgren with Water Shuriken. As he goes for Shadow Ball, water does absolutely nothing, yeah. That's definitely not a boosting item. Yeah, he has the Greninja with Water Shuriken and Zygarde that checks non-HP Ice Volk. But HP Ice Volk is not, like, it's not super common, but they run it sometimes, especially if they're paired with Dugtrio. But yeah, Heatran gets up some chip damage, gets back the leftovers. He has a free protect here, which means the Zygarde will be brought into range to die from hazards, so it can switch out. And then he can just suck off his Greninja, because I don't think he needs that anymore. So he basically sucks off his Greninja here. Heatran is still nice. For Tapu Lele, that clicks a Psychic or Moonblast, because it obviously resists both of those. Photons resists Moonblast. So he clicked Shadow Ball with the Tapu Lele. I think he predicted the Latias again earlier. He sets the Gohard into his Zygarde, which is okay, because it lives. Oh my god, that did nothing. If that's really bad, that's Bennett, right? That Zygarde 8. So he can't e-speed this because of terrain, but this game has been over for a while. He doesn't have to make any plays here, P2. I think he can just stay in. He can either stay in or... Yeah. Goes into Heatran, wow. Wow, he goes for Moonblast. Now it looks like he get completely played. I think P2 was just willing to sack his Heatran. I wouldn't have gone hard Heatran probably, but it's not that it made a big difference, because he had like so many ways to win that game. That burn just speeds up the process. Yeah, he can go for Protect or switch into... I don't know, it doesn't really matter at this point if he sacked something else or if he went for Protect. Unless his Landris pulled out the rest on the Protect and then showed some wild set Resto Chesto, but it was over anyway, because if it's Resto Chesto, it's slower than Greninja, so Greninja would come in and revenge with Ice Beam. Like, it would either kill this or kill the Lily, because T-Spikes plus Rocks plus Ice Beam would obviously kill the Lily, but yeah, I assume, unless he gets like Superman Roll. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I think that was P2's first game, unless I missed another game that he played, but I was online a lot last days and I recorded so many games for you guys, and I did never see P2 play, but yeah, picked up the win for UK, and Hector is 0-2, so it doesn't look, it's not looking too good for him. I think his team is doing okay, but yeah, he himself is not doing too well. Yesterday, he played versus Hero, and he had a SD Tapu Bulu. And he went for SD, and the opponent had like a Ferrothorn or something, and it was Chopper Barrel Ferrothorn. He got bopped by Gyarados, so that didn't work out for him. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. See you next time. I'll leave a replay to that game in the description, and peace out.